I'm a state representative for District 87, which includes four counties up in the Panhandle. And in this region, obviously, a lot of water use is irrigated agriculture. So I want to focus on conservation techniques that will improve the use of our water up here, because it's such a heavy use of the Ogallala Aquifer and the water that we so dearly value up here. But I also want to talk about practical obstacles to implementation. When we start the next session, we're going to be facing, in all likelihood, severe budgetary crisis like we did in the 82nd legislative session. We also have school finance issues. And what I don't want to see are some of those issues overwhelm what's really important, which is the water issues we're going to be discussing today. We have to change a mindset among our general population about how important our water resource is. And up here in this region, you know, we have a planned depletion, model where the Ogallala Aquifer is being utilized, and we're not able to recharge like other areas of the state. And once that water's gone, it's gone. And I think, it's not always in everyone's consciousness that this is a resource that we can't live without, that it's going away the more we use it. And if we don't take serious efforts to conserve it and educate kids and adults alike, we're not going to change the mindset that it needs to be valued properly and it needs to be used properly. I've seen a lot of good work from our groundwater conservation districts and farmers participating in test programs and things of that nature here to see, what can be grown with drought-resistant seed variations, different watering techniques. So yes, I think that we all recognize, and probably farmers more than anybody, that if they are going to have economic viability for the long term, they have to understand and participate in ways to make it so that this water is being conserved, because the last thing we want up here is restrictions of the variety that make it economically impossible to sustain an agriculture base or a lifestyle that is so important to our area. So, yeah, absolutely, I think the farmers are doing a great job.
You mentioned earlier that the effort involves an education program with the kids. Are there programs right now going on with the local schools?
There are. There's programs that are going on. I know High Plains Groundwater Conservation District had undertaken a very good program. I was in Austin a few weeks ago and just visited the LCRA, the Lower Colorado River Authority. They've got an excellent program. They bring thousands of children through their facilities, and they teach them the value of conserving water. They teach them what happens when water goes back into the ground, and they do some demonstrations hands-on that really, I think, helps kids understand that, all of their actions as they grow up, from, parking their car in a parking lot, to disposing of the oil, to watering their lawn, just the things that we do every day, how that really makes it a difference and how it affects their drinking water and their water supply. So it's fabulous, and that really will make a difference. So those kind of programs, I think all the river authorities and all the groundwater conservation districts ought to continue that, and the ones that aren't actively doing it really should, because in the long run it's going to benefit all of us. The thing that folks really need to understand is it is a depleting resource, and we're not making more water. Most of the water that we're going to have for our future needs is going to come from conservation efforts, and that's part of our state's water plan. And if they understand that, and if they understand where their water comes from, and that it can be reused in certain instances, and we can, build desalination plants, and we can do some things to actually really improve our supply down the road, I think they'll be more engaged, I think it'll be better, and I think the state will, in a broad sense, be more willing to find resources to pay for some of these initiatives. So things like matching grants and all would be really helpful.
You mentioned desalination projects. Are a lot of those going on around the state, or are we still behind the curve on that?
In my opinion, we're behind the curve. There are some projects that are going on, and El Paso is sort of the, in my opinion right now, the leading example of how successful it can be. It is expensive, and that's really the biggest drawback. The engineering is there and the science is there. Keeping the cost it down is something that's really been problematic. But, we have over 2 billion acre feet of water in Texas, brackish water, mm-hmm. that can be utilized. So, it's something I don't think we can avoid to analyze thoroughly.
I understand in the new water plan, the 2012 plan, that as much as one-third of the incremental supply of water, say by 2060, we hope will come from conservation. Do you think that's an effort that we can achieve?
Well, I'm optimistic. I think it is. You know, if you look at the city of San Antonio as an example, for instance, in the last few decades, they've really undertaken an aggressive conservation effort to educate their citizens, to advocate the use of low-flow toilets, urinals, showerheads, that sort of thing, water restrictions on their lawns, really getting with their industries to reuse water where appropriate. And they do an aquifer, I think, storage and recovery program there that really also helps them. And as a result, they've reduced their water usage by 42% mm-hmm. over a period of time where their population has really been increasing. So that's just a small example. But if we had a global effort in that regard, or at least a statewide effort in that regard, I think we'd see the fruits of that labor. So I'm optimistic that we can achieve it. And really, the good news is we do have plans. You know, plans are being drawn, you know, and revised all the time. The problem's recognized, and the engineering and science, I think, are there. The bad news is people, politics, and money. You know, we have to make sure that our citizens are engaged in the process, that one, they understand that this is really a crisis. It's not just a drought issue. It's an issue that needs to be dealt with both in and outside the drought. It's also something that we don't need to think in 2 or 4 year election cycles to address. You know, the solutions to these water problems are going to take decades to solve. So what we really need is to change the mindset so that we think more corporately and we think longer term and we get folks involved. And then money, of course, is a huge issue, because it's going to cost a lot of money to start solving some of these issues. And the sooner we start, the less expensive it's going to be. We've seen that back in the 60s, the projected plans, had they been enacted, would have cost the state somewhere around $3 billion. Well, here we are, those weren't enacted, and it could cost the state between $27 and $53 billion to enact some of the infrastructure needs that we're facing now. And if we don't do it by 2060, that number could exceed $200 billion. So, you know, the cost of not doing something far outweighs the, you know, the, I guess, the benefit of doing it now. The biggest issue to me is, with regard to conservation, is education. We really have to make sure that our citizenry is engaged, and they're educating their peers, and make sure that they engage their city managers, make sure that their mayors, their city commissioners, their council members, they're all aware of the need to address this issue at a local level. Our planning is a ground-up plan. It receives input from all the different regions across the state about how best to affect our water development and conservation. And so it needs to also start from the ground up. And so that will have an impact. Make sure your state representatives and senators are comfortable knowing that they can make some long-term decisions without, you know, the immediate gratification or fruits of that labor being realized tomorrow or next year. Because, as I said, I think the solutions to some of these issues are going to take decades to to result in beneficial effects for the state of Texas. So I think education about the issue is step number one. And programs like this are fantastic, because we've got great turnout. People will leave here better educated. They'll be able to talk to their colleagues and their peers, and that will make a difference.
WATRnews.com.